last year. We experienced heavy rains across the country. And out of it, Tana was most hit from the floods from the river and from the hinterland, and swept away all the other crops and brought down houses and many other properties, including the water supply system in Bura town. It is not fair for national government to say that the Bura and the Hola irrigation farmer pays a debt of 67,000 something, close to 70 million, 67.5 million, around there. Taking 67.5 million, again, heap it on the farmer will not be any fair. It will sound to be one of the very unfairest government to its people. 67.5 million or 70 million or 100 million. I don't find it to be too much for a government to waive to its own citizens, especially citizens that are already going on through all this. In fact, you know that even the Minister for Devolution, as part of the government program, has been mobilizing food to supply again to Utara. So how come today they see it as a need to support the farmers, the people of Tana in food, to get food, and the same government is turning again to say this farmer has to pay 67.5 million? What is it that informed them to see the need to help the farmers in relief food? And which is this government again that has seen the need also to tell this same person to pay 67.5 million. And that's why I'm pleading with them to reconsider their decision and look for funds from their own sources to waive this debt for the farmer. And then from there, we can be able to sit and discuss on the entire question of how to improve food security in Tana, in Bura, in Hola, and the rest of the schemes.